Hey guys, this is Ulrich from Nostalgic Mathematics. Welcome to our MID Integration B2022 series. Today we turn attention to the problem 1 of the second semifinal. We will compute this integral. If you are new here, do not forget to subscribe. So we are given this messy looking function f with infinite nested absolute values. And we want to compute the integral of this function from minus 1 to 1. Sometimes they are trying to value. So what you need to do is to keep calm and watch carefully all the details before even trying to compute this integral. So let's go through some of these details. First, f is an even function because of the absolute value x here. Second, all the terms 2 over 3, 2 over 3 square, and so forth, all these terms sum up to 1. Actually, we use the formula involving the infinite sums of the terms of a geometric series. Number 3, which is a trap actually, do not try to evaluate the function f. Actually, people should compute these integrals in 3 minutes. It's true that we are not taking the counters, but this gives us a clue that the key does not lay there. So instead, try to find an equation satisfied by I. That's what we're going to do in this solution. So let's try. Because f is an even function, I equals 2 times the integral from 0 to 1 of fx dx. So we can focus on fx over the set of real positive numbers. So we have this, we can just get rid of this absolute value x to have this expression. Now, because of the term absolute value of x minus 2 over 3, we see that we have a symmetry axis here in 2 over 3. Because when we do f of 2 over 3 plus h, this will become absolute value of h. So this is the same as doing f of 2 over 3 minus h, because actually absolute value of h is also absolute value of negative h. Now, we use these boundaries 1 over 3 because we don't want to go past 1, because 2 over 3 plus 1 over 3 is going to be 1, because we're integrating from 0 to 1. That's what you have here. So f has a symmetry axis on the interval 1 over 3 and 1. So what we do next is that we split the integral. So we write the integral from 0 to 1 is the integral from 0 to 1 third plus the integral from 1 third to 1. And this integral here is I over 2 because of this equation. So basically, I over 2 is going to be the integral from 0 to 1 third of fx dx. Now we do this variable change because of this equality. So we set x equals 2 over 3 plus h. Then dx is dh. And h will go from negative 1 over 3 to 1 over 3. Now, this function is an even function in h because of this result. So this turns out to be 2 times the integral from 0 to 1 over 3 of this expression. Next, we will evaluate f of 2 over 3 plus h. So we write here, so we have absolute value of h. So what we want to do is that we want to have the same sequence of number as here, 2 over 3, 2 over 3 squared, and so forth. So basically what we do is that we factor by 1 over 3 to have this. And here we have absolute value of 3h. So all of this is going to be f of 3 times h. So we have this relationship. So we plug in into this integral. So we have I over 2 is the integral from 0 to 1 third of fx dx. And then here we have 1 over 3 f of 3h. So next we do another substitution, setting h equals x over 3. So here, dh is going to be dx over 3. So we're going to have dx over 9 here. And x will go from 0 to 1. And we have this result. But we know that 2 times the integral from 0 to 1 of fx dx is also I. So the whole quantity here is I over 9. And then we have the equation I over 2 equals the integral from 0 to 1 over 3 of fx dx plus I over 9. So we have established that I over 2 is this integral plus I over 9, which is equivalent to 7 over 18i equals the same integral. And therefore, I is 18 over 7, the integral from 0 to 1 third of fx dx. So we want to evaluate this integral. So we just focus on fx first. We know that fx is given as follows. And because here x is less or equal to 1 over 3, we know that x minus 2 over 3 is negative. So therefore, absolute value of x minus 2 over 3 is 2 over 3 minus x. Again, we focus on 2 over 3 minus x. Again, because x is less or equal to 1 over 3, we know that 2 over 3 minus x is greater or equal to 1 over 3. But remember, we have also established that this infinite sum equals 1. So if we pass 2 over 3 to the right, we're going to have that 1 minus 2 over 3, which is 1 over 3, equals the infinite sum in blue. So 1 over 3 here in blue equals that infinite sum in blue. So that inequality rewrites as follows, which is very important because it allows us to get rid of the absolute values here. Because at this first stage, we know that 2 over 3 minus x minus 2 over 3 squared is equal to this quantity, 2 over 3 cubed plus dot, 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 dot. It is positive. So we can get rid of the absolute value. And we do the same reasoning, and then we get rid of all the absolute values. So fx equals 2 over 3 minus x minus this infinite sum. We know that the infinite sum here is 1 over 3, and fx simplifies as 1 over 3 minus x, and this is now easy to integrate. So this integral from 0 to 1 over 3 is the integral from 0 to 1 over 3 of this function. It equals to x over 3 minus x squared over 2 evaluated from 0 to 1 over 3, which is equals to 1 over 18. And using this equation, I equals 18 over 7 multiplied by 1 over 18, and it simplifies, and I equals 1 over 7, and this is the answer. Thank you for your attention. Again, do not forget to subscribe, like, share, and post your comments. Bye.